Hello and welcome back to another video. So a few of the students in my program are into jewelry. They do jewelry design and renders and stuff like that, and a lot of them wonder, like, how do you set up the right materials and create something photorealistic when it comes to jewelry rendering? A lot of them can do the modeling and the designs and stuff, but they don't know how to get their renders looking really good. So in this video, we're going to focus mostly on render settings and materials, so you can produce something good looking. So it's going to be very quick, and I'm just going to show you pretty much like basics for setting up materials so you can just quickly get a good look. So if we start off over here, we see this is our jewelry scene, and we start off with something more basic so we can get a good look of our materials and our setup. So if I turn this on over here, this is a good material setup that's going to work in a lot of lighting scenarios and stuff. You don't really have to change your materials and stuff that much. So pretty much when it comes to things like metals, very simple. Just a standard glossy material, specular is up to 1. Roughness you can have a little bit, or you can turn it down to 0, but you don't really need any bump or scratches or any like little details like that to get something that looks good. And then the index between like 5 and 8 is really good for metals, and that's pretty much for this material here. So that's that one. And then there's just the diamond, which is just a simple specular material, no roughness, reflections up to 1. And then your index is a key here, so you can Google index of refraction for diamonds and stuff like that. Find them on Google, find out which ones applies to your diamond or whatever kind of stone or rock you're using. Put it in here, and then it should be accurate. Transmission, 95% is fine, and that gives it a little bit of like non-transparency. If it's like 100%, it's fully transparent. If it's 0, it's not transparent at all, pretty much. So 95% is like pretty accurate, and I'll leave that there. And then the key here is your dispersion coefficient. If you change this, this is where you get those refraction of light inside the actual diamond and stuff like that. And then that's when you get like those colors and stuff that you'll see in real diamonds and stuff. So here you can see I've just got this value here, which works pretty good to give me something that's pretty realistic in terms of like getting those color bending and stuff on the inside. And then so long as your actual diamond itself here, you just make sure that this Phong tag isn't basically rounding off everything, and you're making sure that it's nice hard edges. And you've got nice closed up diamonds and the modeling is all done right, then you should get something that looks pretty accurate with the rendering. Now with the render settings, this is also quite important. You want to make sure you're on path tracing. You want to make sure you have global illumination. Otherwise, you won't get like the kind of light bounces that you need. Like you'll see here, if I turn this up to 100, you'll see there's like light bounces all over the show. And that's what gives it that photorealistic look when there's enough light bouncing around. Your specular depth can be all the way up to 50 if you want a lot of bounces in here and you want like a lot of these dark spots to actually have light passing through. You can see there's some dark spots here where there isn't as much light passing through. You can turn that up all the way up to 50 to get those clear. Otherwise, in this render, I just used 16 and it looked fine. And that's pretty much it for getting something that looks photorealistic. There's a lot of other settings for actually optimizing your renders and stuff like that to make them faster and stuff when it comes to jewelry. But in this case, that's pretty much a basic setup that you need for a lot of jewelry renders. The only thing you need to change here, if you want the color to be different, is you can change like the transmission here. You can change like the color of the transmission to get like different color diamonds and stuff if you want like something that's gold or like a red ruby color like this one. Otherwise, you can just kind of leave it clear. So that's pretty much it. Then the rest is just making the scene look good. Here you can see like this is a basic white scene. This is more to do with like lighting, the positioning of the cameras, all that stuff. But in my case, all I did was this. You have a HDRI, set up the lights correctly for your jewelry, and then just have a nice environment, and all the other stuff kind of adds up to produce something kind of like this. So hope this helps quite a lot of you when it comes to jewelry. Very, very simple setup. Not diving too deep into lighting when it comes to jewelry and too deep into like render settings and setting them up and making like something look super, super professional. But like, hopefully this will help a lot of you, especially if you just want to know like quick settings when it comes to like setting up your renders, materials and stuff for jewelry in Octane, so you can create something photorealistic really quickly. And if you don't really know much about that stuff and you're pretty much good with like modeling and stuff like that. So hopefully this helps. This project will be on Patreon. If you want to download it, just take all the assets and stuff and see what's in there. I'll be posting this on Patreon, so you can go subscribe there as well. You can check out my free training that I still have available, all in the link description, if you want to check those out. Otherwise, I'll see you on the next video. I'll see you soon. Have a good day.